So it's time to move HQ. We're doing it Egyptian style. It's just me and the wife today. I got some nice round cedar logs that are stripped, so they should be pretty smooth. I'm throwing down some 2x6 on the ground just to let them roll a little bit easier. We're gonna hook on. I got an aircraft cable, 1/4 inch, so it's good for 5,000 pounds or so. We're gonna hook that on. I got about 100 feet. We're gonna hook that down to a tree. Use a little come along. I got a 4-ton come along. So inch by inch, we're gonna start moving this. I'll set up the time lapse so you don't have to watch me agonize for hours to get this done. But it's finally getting done. Basshogg HQ move.
Break it down with the tumblelands, got a long lens come around. With a bombed out girl skyline southbound on the ground. Some here I don't get, some here I don't see. Go boys coming down and it's on to the fucking teeth. It's a long way to Neverland and I'm dying to shoot him down, keep him down for good. Yeah, I might live dual lives, here I am 20 years to the day like I knew I would. Get a stone on a hot sand, put in a call to Colleen. Get a bottle to drop down all the images from the street.
All right, so two of the come along cable lengths in. I'm about 13 to 14 feet ahead. About a half hour, 45 minutes in, and it's time for a break. That's pretty sad, but whew. Even with all the tools, it's still not light. Just so we're on the same page, this is not fun. If my truck had a big chrome bumper on the front, I'd be pushing this shed. And if my stupid ass hadn't misplaced the keys to take off my trailer hitch, I'd be reverse pushing this shed. Day two of the great shed move of 2024. Yesterday we managed to move it about maybe 18 feet in total, but we had to back it up a good 20 feet and we moved it forward. So 38 feet in total moving, but now we have almost a straight shot down to where it's gonna go. I'm just gonna keep dragging it. I don't know if you can see that from here, but it's all wired up to a tree stump way down there, another 90 feet or so. So I'm gonna set up the time lapse and start cranking. Thank you. Alright, problem 21. The shed's starting to cant itself. My god.
I see my redhead mess bed tear shed queen bee must squeeze. The stage smells, tells, hells, bells, misspells, knocks me on my knees. It didn't hurt, flirt, blood, squirt, stuff, shirt like me on a tree. After I count down three rounds, and hell, I'll be in good company.
The best way to learn is to do. That's the way I think of it. You do stuff, you learn as you go, you know, watch some cool YouTube videos and tackle it. However, it's always nice to have a tip or two before you start something, and here's my tip of the day so far. When you're pulling on your come along and it starts getting wicked tight, going back and forth, there's probably a reason for that. And with each extra crank that you do, you're probably screwing yourself for at least an hour of unfucking the mess you just made.
Pushing past the limit, tripping on hallucinogenics. My cigarette burnt my finger, 'cause I forgot.
Welcome to day 3. My arms are killing me. My back is killing me. The shed is moved quite a bit. I have about 30 feet to go straight, and then it's going to be the somehow agonizing task of moving at 90 degrees. I think I have a plan, but I have two plans in case one plan fails. We'll get to that. I'll do another little cutout when we get to that point. So for this morning, just we're going a little bit uphill. It's a sandy, new sandy area. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take 10 minutes and empty the shed out. I probably have about 500 pounds of extra mishmash in there, so I'm feeling like, since my body's not feeling up to it today, I'm just gonna take a few minutes, take the extra weight out of that thing, and make life a little bit easier, and then we're gonna go from there, and we'll get the time lapse going, and here comes day 3.
Call back to the like the wayward sun. And now through and through I have come undone. And now I am just but the wayward man. What with my bloodshot eyes and my shaky hand. Cause I carry on like a wayward son. And now through and through I've come undone. And now I am just but the wayward man. What with my bloodshot eyes and my shaky hand. Pushing past the limit, tripping on hallucinogenic. My cigarette burnt my finger, cause I forgot I lit it.
Okay, so we're starting phase two of today, which is the twist. So I have a plan A, which involves pulling from a back corner. I'll just flip the camera around here so you can kind of see. I have an extra strap tied onto the back corner for this tree back here. So hopefully it's gonna help move this corner here that way. So the front of the shed ends up facing this way.
Stretch out your legs, let me make you fall. Drive you insane, drive you up the wall. Staring at your known piece, very strong. Stronger than pride, stronger than Teflon. Take it on the Ave and you buy me links. Now I want a pound of until it stinks. You could be my mama and I'll be your boy.
Original road boy, never am I coy. You could be a shorty in my ill convoy. Not to come across as a thug or a hood. What? But hun, you got the goods like Madeline Wood. By the way, my name's Malik, the 5 foot freak. They say we get together by the end of the week. She simply said no, label me a. I said how you figure, my friends tell me so. I hate when silly groupies wanna run their yap. Word to God, hun, I don't get down like that.
I'll have you weak in the knees that you can hardly speak. Or we could do like Uncle Ella, swing it up in my Jeep. Keep it on the down, yo, we keep it discreet. See, I'm not the type of kid to have my biz in the streets.
If my mom don't approve, then I'll just be low. Let me save the little man from inside the boat. Let me hit it from the back, girl, I won't catch a hernia. Off on your couch, now you got Siemens furniture.
Shy, he fight for the extra P. Stacy Beetle, PJ, and my man LG. They know the ass track is really so on ice. The character is of man, never ever a mice. Shorty, let me tell you about my only vice. It has to do with lots of loving, and it ain't nothing nice. It ain't nothing nice.
Start of day four. So we're at a little bit of an impasse at the end of yesterday. So here's the shed. We still have about 12 feet to go. And as you can see, it's facing the exact place we want it to face, straight down from the cottage in the little lane that we dug out. Pushing it straight back wasn't as easy as I thought. I was hoping that just having it on the cedar poles would just allow it to slide on the poles. It didn't want to do that. So what we're doing now, we switched the poles up for 2x6, 2x6x12s, and we're gonna put two layers of those. So if I'm right, they should just slide on top of each other, kind of like a deck of cards. It's just gonna slide. So the beams underneath the shed are gonna dig into the top 2x6, but the bottom 2x6 should allow the top one to just slide right across it. So 10 to 12 feet. And I'm cheating. Once I have it all set up, I rigged up the shed to accept my trailer hitch. And I'm shoring up the inside walls so it doesn't collapse it. So a little bit of shoring up to do, and then I'm just gonna push this sucker back. And once I get it back within about a foot, I'm assuming it'll be off a little bit. Then I'll break out the cables again and start moving it. So I'm gonna start the time lapse back up. I just gotta gather a couple more pieces of 2x6, which are obviously on the bottom of my wood pile, but it shouldn't be long. Alright, Basshogg HQ has been moved. The red shed is in its final spot. I've put in some patio stones and deck blocks underneath it to give it a better support over the softer ground back there, so it's not going to go anywhere. We started halfway through Sunday and finished halfway through Wednesday, so I'll call it 3 full days of work. My body is beat down. This is our first kind of big project. Well, second, I guess. We took down a lot of trees in the last couple of weeks, but this was early in the year to take on a beast of a project like this. Everything hurts. But now it's time to, I'm gonna get this thing painted in the next couple of weeks and start finishing off the inside and make it more of a adult fishing playhouse than anything else. It's been used for storage right up till now. It's 18 by 8 feet, so there's a good space. We'll be able to put all my rods in there and a little workbench and things like that. TV, bar fridge, the goods. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the time lapse. Egyptian style, moving a big shed. Whew, time for a beer.